Just come home. Solo con te io sospiro tutta la notte.
Rome, I really recommend that you stay at least 3 to 4 days. There's so much to see, and after all, Rome wasn't built in a day. However, sometimes, of course, circumstances make that just not possible. My dad only had 1 day to visit Rome before he had to fly out, so here's how we did Rome in 1 day. We started off at the Trevi Fountain. Usually this place is packed, but we got there early in the morning and there was no one there, which is cool. After that, we headed to the Colosseum. We purchased Skip the Line tickets ahead of time, which I definitely recommend doing because it saved us a lot of time. And instead of doing a guided tour, we downloaded Rick Steves' Audio Guides Europe app, which is free and also handy if you're short on time. Our ticket included the Roman Forum, which is nearby. Both together took us about 2 hours. For lunch, we stopped at a cafe to eat tramezzini, and then we went home to change our clothes before heading to the Vatican since the Vatican does have a dress code. We also purchased Skip the Line tickets for the Vatican, but honestly, we went at 6 p.m. and there was hardly anyone there at that time. Like, no one. We ended the night with dinner where we got bruschetta and, of course, carbonara, which Rome is famous for. And that's how we did Rome in 1 day.
Make me if it's all part of a dream, cause maybe it feels like heaven. Mon chéri, bonsoir, enchanté. Your hands on my face, embrasse-moi, mon soleil. Say you die for me, babe.
Here are the best free things to do in Rome and when. Coming in at number one is the Villa Borghese, which is Rome's most famous and iconic park full of shaded walkways. Coming in at number two is the Trevi Fountain, which you don't have to throw coins into. You can just enjoy it for free. Now, of course, everyone knows the Colosseum, and of course, it is absolutely free to see, but did you know that on the first Sunday of the month, it's free to enter too? The museums of the Vatican are not free, except for the last Sunday of the month. That's when you should go. And the most iconic thing that you can do for free in Rome is the Passeggiata, which is a true cultural experience that makes you look and feel like a local. These are just some of our favorite free things to do in Rome. Tell us what city we should do next.
Traveling in Rome. Book a hotel in a central location. Don't miss out on the pastries and cappuccinos. Be prepared to walk a lot. Take the metro. Wake up at sunrise for an empty Trevi fountain. Book guided tours. We use the app Viator. Order an antipasto. Book a horse and carriage ride. Tour local churches. Walk around the city at night.
Okay, Trevi Fountain and there.
Thank you. but I wanna buck up and not alone right now. Whoa, my head is in the clouds in my white
cold world. Southside, can't get enough, can't get enough. East side, west side.
Please meet me in the plaza near your casa. I am only one, and that is one too few.
How you look and stare so deep in your eyes. I touch on you more and more every time.
This is one amazing place in Rome you have to visit, but lots of people never think to visit. It's called Santa Maria del Popolo. Why do you have to visit it? Because in this church you'll find some of the most famous paintings in the world by some of the most famous artists in this world. We're talking Raphael, Bernini, Caravaggio. It's just amazing.
Boutique hotel Campo di Fiori is located right in the historic district, meaning you can reach hotspots like the Pantheon, Trevi Fountain, and Piazza Navona in no time. The Yellow is a classic European hostel for the younger and more social crowds. Here, you can start your day with rooftop yoga, join a free tour during the afternoon, and let loose come nightfall at the Yellow Bar. Generator Rome is located near the Colosseum and Termini Station, and with beds starting at a budget-friendly 15 euros per night, both the price and location are very hard to beat.
I'm in Rome, and I'm walking around looking at the map, and I see this. Obviously, I have to go. I love cats.
So let's go.
You guys, it's just cats chilling in Roman ruins, in the middle of Rome.
Ruins, ruins, ruins. Cats.
Like, what? Hi. Oh,
what did I stumble in on?
I knew that I was going to stumble upon ruins in Rome. Like cats in ruins? I didn't expect that.
On an evening in Roma, do they take them for espresso? Yeah, I guess so. On each lover's arm, a girl I wish I knew.
You need to listen to this.
Baby, you got me. It ain't nowhere that I'll be. Then with your arms around me, back and forth you rock me. So
just a few steps away from the Trevi Fountain, there's a hidden architectural gem that most people have no idea is even here. I'm talking about Galleria Sciarra. Built for the Palazzo Sciarra Colonna as an inner courtyard between 1885 and 1888. It uses modern technology of the time, like an iron wrought ceiling, glass dome to close it all up, but the true gem here are the Art Nouveau paintings by Giuseppe Cellini. If you look behind the beautiful flowery scrolls, you're gonna see the true theme in here, Glorificazione della Donna, a theme of glorifying and unifying women, and all female virtues, including justice, patience, fidelity, and strength are here. You can find this by simply going away from the Trevi Fountain, find a McDonald's, go behind it, enter into this courtyard. It's completely free. I hope you enjoyed that. If you wanna know more about Rome and Italy, follow me, I'll lead the way.
Random Cool Things in Rome, Part 4. There are no skyscrapers. In fact, it's actually against the law to build anything taller than St. Peter's Basilica. This means that no matter where you are in the city or what you're doing, you're only moments away from an incredible view.